What's up, everybody? Welcome to NIBScast episode 39. I am one of your hosts, Aaron Lamping, joined as always by the Fallout Pit Boy himself, Nikki 13.
Dude, I can't wait for 30 more episodes when it's episode 69 and it's just the sound of us making love.
Yeah, that's...
I don't know why I decided to lock eye contact with you.
He's upward bound, Jordan Diaz.
Hello, I'm Jordan Diaz.
That program was...
Gross.
That was an enjoyable program. I was glad that I got to vicariously live through it with you.
Yes, I'm glad to live that through
it. Especially those upward bound counselors that like forced you to do your homework.
You mean my taskmasters?
Yes.
With their whips.
Whoosh.
Yeah.
And he's a blank gray slate, Seth Talon.
Hello.
You have a t-shirt on underneath?
Yeah.
What's it say?
Star Wars.
The Star Wars himself.
The Star Wars kid.
Have you changed clothes since the last time I talked to you?
No, these are just my Saturday clothes.
I was supposed to say, last time I saw him was last Saturday and he was wearing that
he
shirt.
He only washes his Saturday clothes at the beginning of every month. So luckily they're
no,
fairly
clean. No, I did laundry yesterday.
Well, if you think about it, you only wear it four times.
And
fair.
That's
fair.
You know, some days.
And I couldn't tell you the last time I washed this pair of jeans.
By that logic.
And it's my only pair of jeans.
By that logic, they're clean right now.
I mean, they are because I washed them last night.
See, you had to get ready for Saturday.
I mean, I do laundry every week.
It's just the thing.
Yeah, but
you
don't
do. You don't wash the Saturday clothes until the first of the month.
That's silly.
I doubt it.
Well,
you're silly.
Stop putting things.
I'll spread those pants and underwear out to at least get 2 weeks before I have to do laundry.
You got four uses on underwear: normal, backwards, inside out, backwards. You got four uses out of a pair of underwear.
That's so true.
Man, I probably do the most laundry here. Damn.
Wow.
It's because you're not efficient. You need to be efficient.
Don't talk to me about efficiency. I'll kick your ass in efficiency in pretty
wasteful
much any video
American.
Game play.
Yeah, this guy's a.
I always go for efficiency in games.
He mid maxes.
Yeah.
I don't like to fish in the sea.
He wants to get the most out of his short time.
He's the guy that fishes in WoW.
But I don't fucking fish.
They need to just,
you're not being
they need to put that on a cell phone app already.
Please and thank you. I'm sick of just like putting my line
and
out.
And make those secondary professions account bound. No reason.
Yeah. Like why are they not account bound?
Because you're just gonna hop onto your character they can. And you know what, for that matter, while they're doing it, just make the primaries.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna fish.
Or just let you do all of them.
I'm not gonna
see
fish
they
700
to do that
times
with garrisons.
See, that could at least make. I mean, if you're going, you might as well go all the way. But my thought there is, then at least you have to level up other characters. You can only level 2 per character, but you can use them all
in some way.
Garrison 2.0.
Maybe you should just make Garrison auto.
Dude, if you could have your other fucking toons on that server, just hang out in your garrison.
That would be pretty awesome.
That'd be fucking sweet.
You could just go and say hi to them.
Yeah,
like your garrison shared.
Well, you're the ones that are
account.
In the same faction.
Well,
because
too bad we're going to be spending all our time in class halls, and that won't matter unless all your characters are
unless
the same
class hall
maybe,
is the new
maybe
garrison.
Maybe you have 10. It is.
I have,
but the thing
I
is, like
10
your rogue's not
going to
want to go hang out with your warlock.
What are you, Phil?
It's lost in Warcraft lore. Warlocks are the scum of the earth.
Yeah,
nobody wants to be with them. Your rogue isn't going to want to go visit them.
Well, no, because there's worse now. Fucking demon hunters.
Oh, good point.
Yeah, they're worse.
Well, I bet they don't like each other.
Demon hunters are racist.
It's going to be like District 9. The warlocks are going to be like, yay, somebody else to hate.
I forgot about that movie.
It's a good movie.
It's a good movie.
I only saw it once.
That was one of the first things I watched on Netflix streaming, like just sat down and watched one day.
Yeah. That's not a bad movie.
Okay. Good to jump right in with some news this week. Of course, as I say that, my document closes.
Right.
Do. Okay, so Thursday.
We talked shortly in episode 3 or 4 of the Metal Gear Solid playthrough about one of the bullet points in there. Not the bullet point itself, but like it's the Final Fantasy VII one that we'll get to. I was like, ooh! I'm sorry, we're going to talk about this in like an hour when we start doing the podcast, but I'm excited, so I'm going to talk about it now.
I mean, this will probably go up first.
No, it absolutely will.
All right, so the Game Awards were on Thursday night. Telltale came out swinging. They had 2 announcements to announce. Their first one is they have a Batman game coming out.
I could dig that.
Lifting the silence on... They said a while ago, we're working with DC. We're going to have something.
Yeah,
they just never said what. So I was interested that it was Batman. Like, I figured maybe with all the Batman games and stuff that have been out...
I think a Batman point-and-click adventure would be perfect.
I'm confident it will work. I'm confident it will work, but
I wonder if a lot of it will be like from Bruce Wayne's perspective, maybe.
Like, you got to think at some point they got to be heading toward Justice League with this stuff.
It's like possibly the duck from...
That'd be awesome, dude.
Because I'm interested. I know WB, their studios, have two games in development that they have said nothing about. What do you... Like, what would you guys want next from DC?
You know what I want? You know what I want? A fucking Flash game. I don't know how you do it without it sucking.
Yeah, how would you do
that? They just reskin the Sonic game for the Dreamcast.
Right. Or you just get a mod for GTA 5 and just put
super high quality, like 2016 texture of the Flash just pasted right on.
Yeah, like Sonic. Not even a different model, just a different fucking texture file.
DC games, besides the Arkham series, have notoriously been kind of bad.
Yeah.
Oh, no, just terrible.
Because, like, everybody... Well, it depends, because, like, Injustice was good.
Injustice, yes. It was a good fight. It's because that was another realm.
Yeah.
Another realm.
Yeah, no, it has nothing to do with...
If it's a fighting game, if it's another realm...
I was about to say, although if you go back to DC versus Mortal Kombat, that was awful.
Yeah, I enjoyed that game. Everyone hates on that.
It doesn't work well.
Granted, at that point, I haven't really played too many Mortal Kombat games.
Well, and it's during the period of NetherRealm where they decided to go the 1990s route of comic book design, where everybody's just boom, fucking Sonya Blade's got biceps like 64 inches around. Like, what the fuck is that?
She had a man face too.
Can I get that chin? Yeah,
it was bad. They brought it over to Injustice 2 with Raven's face. Like, oh,
yeah, but that's because Raven is Raven. Because not all the women in Injustice looked that bad.
Yeah, no, so. I guess most of them were masks too.
But yeah, I would like a Flash game. Green Lantern game would be pretty good.
I think it'd be cool. I keep reading on the internet Superman, which I wouldn't be against if somebody can pitch me how that works.
You get all of the powers. It's literally just a sandbox game where you go around and use all of the powers.
There's not even missions.
You just use all of the powers.
The problem with the Superman game is you can't have a difficulty setting in a Superman game.
Because it's just easy.
If you want to be.
I played one and you couldn't die yourself, but the city had a health bar.
Yeah.
I can't remember which Superman game that was. It was early on the 360, I believe.
It's kind of like the Batman vs. Superman premise, where Batman's all like, you might be a good guy, but you sure are killing a lot of people being a good guy.
Dude, have you guys seen the new trailer?
No.
Oh, I'm going to make you fucking watch that. It's great.
I saw...
It lays out considerably more how things are going to go. Than the other ones. Lex Luthor seems a little, and this is going to sound racist, it's not. Lex Luthor seems a little Jewy.
You'll see what I mean.
It's a good thing Jew's not a race.
It's not. It's not.
I mean, it kind of is.
Hebrew is a race.
Well, Hebrew and Jewish are pretty much the same thing.
But they're not the same thing.
I mean, Puerto Rican. Because
anybody can be a Jew.
Puerto Rican.
I could. What's the word I'm looking for? I want to say transfer, but we're going to go with transfer. I could transfer to Judaism.
Convert.
I could convert to Judaism, and then I'm a Jew, but, like, biologically, I am not Jewish. Of the Hebrew people.
Jewish.
I'm only kind of Jew. Jewish.
He's only a quarter Jew.
Telltale also teased their Michonne Walking Dead game that's coming out next year. It's going to be a 3-episode series starting early next year. She is the samurai.
With the black samurai chick.
She shows up. What's neat about her in the comic book is she shows up in the show. She shows up. She has two walkers as pets.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how she gets around, is they mask the smell. Like,
oh, okay.
Zombies don't smell her because she's around them.
So she's basically one of those dudes in, like, Kenya that carries around hyenas for pets.
Kind of. Comic book spoilers for those who care. What's neat about it is they really don't explain it in the show, is in the comic, it's her boyfriend and her... boyfriend's best friend.
They tell you in the show.
Do they? Yeah. Okay. I don't remember. But she did that because they were dicking around, killed her baby.
Yeah, exactly.
She was all like, they were zombies already, and she's like, you guys are coming with me.
She said she felt remorseful, so that was like her punishment, carrying her burdens with her at all times. It just turns out that they were good for her, because they would ward off the zombies.
Okay.
I watched the last season. I marathoned it.
So... moving on. Far Cry Primal was also shown, and it looks beautiful. Major websites were allowed to publish 30 minutes of gameplay demo after this, which shows off the ability to control cats, wolves, and ride woolly mammoths. It actually looks really cool. Did you guys look at that Wild game at all? I think they showed it off at one of Sony's press conferences. Anyway, it seems like we're moving towards these, like, prehistoric open world games. I'm kind of excited about it. Like, you're chucking spears and bows and
using bows. I actually might check out, what it's called, Primal is what it is? Far Cry Primal. I might check it out. I played 3, didn't get 4 because I felt like there would probably just be more of the same.
I apparently own 3 on Steam. I don't remember buying it.
I've never played a Far Cry game.
My most exciting announcement that, or not my announcement, but the most exciting announcement
to me.
Are
you transing? Sorry.
Tim Schafer came out and announced that Psychonauts 2 could be in development and announced a Fig page, which is similar to Kickstarter, asking for $3.3 million to fund the game, and it would be expected in 2018.
Fuck Tim Schafer.
I was thinking about that. I'm like, I don't care for Tim Schafer, but I like all his games.
No. And it's not even my personal problems with Tim Schafer, although he's an asshole. I like his games. I like Brutal Legend. I like
Brutal
Psychonauts. Legend. Those are the only two that I've played, but I liked them. My problem with it is there is absolutely enough demand, and he's Tim Schafer. He can absolutely get the funding for it. He doesn't need to be doing
this. Last time I checked, it was about 1.5.
So the website says the price is so high because when they asked for money for Broken Age, and it, like, they got 3.3 for Broken Age, and that was, like, way above what they did, so they upped their expectations. And when their expectations got so high, they started putting more and more into the game, and then it was, like, a year late. So they were just like, let's just ask.
Not to mention, I heard that Broken Age.
So he can't work within his means, is what he's saying.
The first act of Broken Age was, like, really amazing. Like, they have awesome voice actors and stuff like that. And then I saw a lot of comments and stuff like that. The second part just didn't live up to the first one.
I don't know. I got it for free on PlayStation Plus 2 or 3 months ago, so I'll be interested in checking that out.
Elijah Wood plays as one of the main
characters. I'm pretty sure Matt or Dylan was playing it recently.
Jack Black voices in there too.
So they had a video, and in it, the voice actors, writers, people who worked on the game in general, it had them all saying, like, I'm in. And the funniest one to me was Eric Wolpaw. He was a writer on the original game. He now works at Valve. It was him and Gabe standing right next to each other, and, like, it was just quiet for a minute, and Gabe was sitting there crossed, armed, and it's just sitting there. It's like, he can be in.
And the dad's like, yeah! Yay!
Lord Gaben has spoken.
Yeah, no, I'm excited for the prospect of Psychonauts 2. I don't like when people who are, like, still in their original incarnation, like fucking Tim Schafer, because he's a name of himself, say, hey, we need this for a sequel. Don't get me wrong, I understand Ukulele is kind of like that. It's a new company. They had no backing, and they have nobody they can turn to because their fucking money was taken.
It should be like an indie exclusive thing to get someone off there.
Because, like, Tim Schafer, yeah, he's not backed directly by Microsoft or anybody like that, but
you're not taking a chance. He's Tim fucking Schafer.
It's Psychonauts 2.
Exactly.
Like, it's already popular.
And, like, Psychonauts, like, people love it and still praise it, and it's not as old as, like, Banjo-Kazooie was. Banjo-Kazooie was old enough that, like, there might not be a market for that anymore.
Yeah.
So they had to figure out whether or not people would buy it.
I think there is, because when Rare Replay came out, like, that sold a ton, and Microsoft were, like, showing some statistics. They're like, yeah, people play Perfect Dark, and they play Banjo-Kazooie, and that's about it.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's also the platformer genre in general, I don't think is not in AAA games anymore.
Well, but I think this is indicative to the point. Like, there's been enough time. People want it again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I feel like the Ukulele Kickstarter was a proof of concept enough that Tim Schafer doesn't have to be like, hey, we need this.
Yeah, it's like, hey, do you guys still want this? And I'm like, yeah, let's go. But Psychonauts are like...
At the same time, you could look at it as if he did seek outside funding, like, from a major corporation, yeah, they would have their hands in it, and they would be able to sway how things
work. Yeah, I understand.
I'll give you that. Steering. Yeah. I don't know. I'm just...
Well, and the breakdown, it looked like one-third was Fig, one-third was private investment, and one-third was actual...
Yeah, they had Fig takes a third...
Well, no, but that, like, the money they're raising, how the money.
Oh, I gotcha. The money that they're getting.
And basically, all I could picture was Notch being all like, I'll give you $3 million if you can raise $3 million.
Well,
I'll match
you. Well, and my that just makes me wonder because like Yooka-Laylee's entire budget is Kickstarter.
Yeah, the entire thing.
So why do they need 1.5 times the amount of money that Yooka-Laylee needs, and that's only a third of their budget?
It's like Shenmue all over
again. Well, we'll get to it a little later. Part of it could be is like Tim Schafer's company's pretty busy right now. Double Fine. So kind of as you said, as of 2 p.m. on the day we're recording, which is 12/5/15, it was at $1.6 million raised.
Okay.
So little bit.
It's going pretty halfway. Good. It's cruising. Yeah. It's cruising.
You know, I'm excited. I'm ultimately excited.
I also saw as like, you know, how they have the tier rewards or whatever. I think if close to $40 or something, you get Psychonauts 1 and 2 on PC.
Yeah, I think the $30 one, you get a reduced price on them, and then the $60 one, you just get both.
Right, something like that. And it says estimated arrival 2018.
Yeah, they're shooting payouts for 2018, but like Broken Age, again, got delayed a year, so you never know.
Yeah, we'll see.
2018?
That's getting close.
What kind of fucking horseshit is that? Ukulele's out mid-next year.
I don't even know what that is.
It's a good
Yooka-Laylee. You get off this podcast now.
I mean, Jordan,
we have an episode about it. I thought you listened to the podcast.
That was probably before I started hanging out with you guys.
That's true. Moving on. The Xenomorph has been announced for Mortal Kombat X.
What? Yes,
I saw that.
Alien versus really cool. Predator. How did I even miss that in the fucking notes?
I don't know. D.
Motherfucker.
I'm excited for the fatalities. Now I have to rebuy
Mortal Kombat.
There better be special interactions between him and Predator.
Oh, did you sell it?
There always is. I traded it in because it was still at a high price, and I figured, you know what, I can get it used later on for a much cheaper price and then make money on it. So.
Yeah. All right.
I won't let that $5 you paid for Goro go to waste. I will buy it back.
Finally, and possibly the biggest thing to come out of the Game Awards, after Metal Gear Solid won its awards for Best Action/Adventure Game and Best Score/Soundtrack, Jeff Keighley announced that Konami had banned Hideo Kojima from attending the Game Awards and accepting any awards for the game. Give me a moment before we all go.
I wasn't gonna go.
Kojima had planned to be at the Game Awards as he is good friends with Jeff Keighley until lawyers apparently told him earlier that week, no, and you're still under contract with Konami. So, sorry. Basically, what this showed me is there was like a 1% chance that he was still there. No, he's done. Like, he's out as soon as he can be.
Yeah.
And my last bullet point on this is hashtag fuck Konami, hashtag free Kojima, is believed that his contract is up sometime this month.
Well.
It's like they grounded him. Like, what the
fuck? Yeah, no, they absolutely did.
It really sucks for him, too, because
it's his baby.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, and they fucking crippled the game.
It was kind of surprising.
We're not going to get into it again.
Where Jeff Keighley's at his place in the industry, like, he's typically, like, he's tiptoes around things, so he doesn't, like,
yeah, no, he step was on anybody. I watched that video. He just went, dunk. Konami is full of shit, is basically what he said.
There were lots of boos.
It was intense. It was intense, because, yeah, he very much does tiptoe around things a lot. He was just very direct, just, Konami won't let him be here, and I think that sucks. He's my friend. I wanted to see him.
It's nice to hear that from him.
Like, I will give him, though. At least he was nice enough to, like, let the people get off the stage.
Yeah. Because,
yeah. I mean, again, and like I posted when I posted this on Facebook, there's some Konami PR person who's just doing their job and was watching that and was like... Why?
He was going to have a nice Christmas with his family, his wife, and kid, and you're just like...
You know what? I don't need this. I quit. We ain't getting Christmas presents this year.
We're done. Sorry. He killed me.
Yeah, I can't handle this.
But it's good because Konami likes to sweep things under the rug, and he just kind of just... He pulled that thing out of the closet.
Well, and their rug is, like, the most lumpy thing in the world. Like, it conceals nothing. But they just kind of go... Next topic?
What?
Like, what was the point in doing that?
Hideo? Is that who are you asking about? I don't know.
We never employed anybody.
His name, that name doesn't appear on any of the games except for the thumbnail on the PS4.
I spent a good hour on Konami's Facebook page just reading the comments. That's fun. Oh, there was lots of just pictures of middle fingers.
Like, this is just childish.
Comment after
comment. It is really
childish. Like, there's no reason for this.
Like, give the guy the credit for what he did.
Yeah exactly. Even if you are
he thought that yeah. series, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. He created Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that is such an injustice to do to one person. I bet he doesn't. I sincerely hope he doesn't care about it. He's just sitting back, like, it's what they did.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Sitting back in his designer glasses. Yeah.
It's like, still one game of the.
Yep.
Well, okay, and then I guess just to say there, the game of the year of the show itself was Witcher 3.
Was anyone surprised?
That's not surprising.
Was anyone surprised about that?
After playing Metal Gear Solid 5, no, I'm not.
Yeah, I heard a lot of things about Metal Gear Solid 5.
You want to hear more? Go listen to the other podcasts.
All right, so moving off the Game Awards, Nintendo's new president, Tatsumi Kimiyoshi, had a Time interview, and in it which he said, paraphrasing, of course, the integration of Nintendo accounts is important to making cell phone games work. So that's their cross thing. And he also echoed the words of Iwata by saying that they won't just release like a Mario Endless Runner just to have Mario in a cell phone game. They will only use these characters when and where it makes sense.
So they won't make like Mario and Luigi nuts and bolts. Because that would be stupid.
I mean, we've gone through this path before. There was a basketball game that had the Mario characters in it. I love that game. But they just put it in there.
It's like, wasn't it like NBA Hoops or something like that?
It was one of those like
street games. Because like they were just kind of thrown in there with real people.
That was during... Because unfortunately, like the GameCube had really good third-party support. Like, that was the last Nintendo... I mean, outside of the Wii, but that was mainly shovelware. Like, the GameCube had good third-party support, and somewhere towards the end of that console's life, everybody was like, it has no third-party games, and everybody believed it, so they were all like, buy the third-party game with Mario in it, please.
Yeah.
Which is weird, because I think that's exactly what the Wii's lacking, is third-party support.
Oh, absolutely.
Like, they need to get their heads together. The same thing that happened to the PS Vita is happening to, Actually, it's the exact opposite.
I was about to say, it's the opposite. The Vita, has third-party support. Yeah,
Vita. Third-party, and that's the only thing you could buy visual novels on nowadays. Anyways.
Your picture books.
Yeah, might
get them out of
here. I mentioned this during, because Matt just got to the fight where you meet Otacon for the first time in Metal Gear Solid. And the fucking line that makes me think of you now, but before was just a ridiculous line to me.
Japanese anime.
Just like one of my Japanese animes.
That's why he's called Otacon.
Yeah. It's short for Otaku Convention.
Yeah. This is why you need to watch Durarara Jordan. There's characters like that. It's great.
Dude, it's honest. It knows what it is. It knows what it is.
He used his time to deny a report that... There was a report a while ago, we actually said it on the show, that... he said the Wii U would be a failure before it came out. Paraphrasing, he said that he thought it could face difficulties being so closely related to the Wii, which he was right.
I'm glad we have him in charge now.
I feel like they just...
Because he has foresight.
Yeah, I just feel like they forgot about it. They didn't do anything with it. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Like, it's not like they had failures. They did some Mario Maker.
I mean, it was their way of testing how to do their form of DLC.
Well,
yeah. Which I think is a good way to do it, especially with what you had told us a month or two ago about how, you know, they want to have, like, one Smash Brothers per console and then update it through DLC. They want to do it with Mario Kart. It also got them a new IP for Splatoon.
Yeah.
It has done quite a bit.
Amiibos.
It's just... It's a mid-step between the Wii and the next actual console.
Yeah, because just in general, the Wii U and the Wii are so similar to each other.
They use the same controllers.
Yes. You just...
And I think it was
push it together.
The Game Informer show I was to. They do a podcast. They were saying, like, even us, the mainstream press, we were sitting there at that E3... And we were looking at each other like, did they announce a console, controller?
Or like a new...
Like, what just happened?
Did they go back a few generations and make like an expansion on the console itself?
Yeah.
Like a fucking 64DDE? Like,
yeah,
the
fuck?
And basically their point was, them, the mainstream media, were thinking that. Mom and Dad...
Oh, yeah, no.
...are gonna...
I don't understand.
It's such a great system. It's sad that they dropped the ball with it.
I feel like they're just being lazy.
I think the NX could be really good.
So to that, he did say the NX would not be in the Wii family. To me, goodbye motion controls. I think they have to go back. They have to go back as much as
mandatory motion
as
controls.
Much as yes, as much as the like Blue Ocean, like we want everybody kind of thing worked for them. I also think long term sustain that hurt them. I think they're gonna go back after the
core. The first Wii was revolutionary. After that,
the first Wii.
Grandma bought the system. Grandma and Grandpa bought the system, played Wii Sports like at the holidays, and put it away.
I'd say that like,
they
was,
didn't keep playing. They
it was
didn't
a
buy games.
Catalyst for a revolution over its entire lifespan and into
it was
the
a
Wii
spark,
U.
Yes,
it created a revolution, but it itself coming on the market was not the revolution.
It was right. Yeah.
The
it
problem
was,
the,
was what started
the Wii to most of those people again, and why I think they have to go back over the core is the sustainability. Most people bought the Wii, got the game they wanted it for bundled in,
mm-hmm. yeah,
and then just used it for that. It was a toy. Yep. It wasn't like something they used all the time. Yeah. They'd put it away.
Well, that brings me back to the this. There's not enough games. Like you look
the
at
the original Wii had plenty of games and they all sucked.
Well, yeah, except the first party ones.
Yeah,
but we're just gonna ignore those.
But again, that's where we're at here with the Wii U.
Like, didn't like Call of Duty World of War on it.
No,
they were just weren't good ports. Those were ports. They weren't just games specifically made for the Wii.
Well, and that's what killed
but
the Wii
third
U.
Party.
Like the Wii U, they're all like, we got the third parties on board, and then Nintendo was like, well, nobody bought the third party, so they stopped. It's like, yes, but it came out with Darksiders 2 and. That these games that you've been playing on your PS3
ports.
And Xbox 360 over a year ago. It's like, of course nobody's
that's
buying
the thing.
That.
It's not just that there were ports, it's that there were old ports.
Yeah. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Like, they have Bayonetta, and that's a first, that's action Nintendo game. And
is it?
The first one
it's
wasn't
an Nintendo,
exclusive,
was
it? The first one was a PS3 and Xbox 360 game. Nintendo funded the second one.
Right.
So
Bayonetta 2 has the exclusive for...
Yeah, but Bayonetta 2 comes with a copy of Bayonetta 1. So Bayonetta was not on a Nintendo console, to my knowledge, at all until Nintendo funded the second one.
Which is
one.
Surprising to me because that game is kind of... something I feel like Nintendo wouldn't really want to go for.
it surprised them, I think. Like,
because there's she's
they
like
needed to make more games like that. We're in the age where the games that will win awards are rated M for mature.
Yeah, but they don't need to win awards.
What I mean, those second parties, like PlayStation this year, outside of their annualized sports game, the MLB that comes from a first party, all their PS4 console exclusives were second party this year.
Yeah,
that's true.
Bloodborne, Until Dawn, they were all like no Sony first party developed those.
Sony doesn't develop a lot. They it's just it's such a
they,
good
they
console
they produce
that,
a lot.
Yeah, they don't have to get their hands into things. They just kind of their word is law over there.
Yeah.
Finally, he's paraphrasing still. He said that amiibos are not being used the way Nintendo had originally thought. He went on to say a lot of people are just collecting these things, which they've sold so many more of these things than they have Wii U's at this point.
Yeah.
That they're all like, oh, like crap. We thought Wii U people would buy these to scan them into the games, but people are just buying them to collect them.
Right.
Which he did come out and say that is a problem on our part. We have to provide a more interesting and appealing way to use these in our software.
Absolutely agree with that. I would probably own more than three of them if I could use them in more ways.
But I mean, like in Smash, it's neat and stuff, but like, all I could think of is like, Skylanders and Disney must be sitting there like, what the hell? We have to make a game for this, for ours to sell, and you guys are just like,
right.
King Dedede.
Yeah, that's exactly. I'm like, it sounds like they're complaining about it, but they're getting. I think they need to get more business oriented in this.
I think their thing is like they, again, like they want you to use this stuff. They don't want you to just set it on a shelf and
be
like,
but they want you to take it out of the package.
Yeah, but at the same time,
yeah, Aaron,
I'm not taking that King Dedede.
At the same time, they're still making tons of money off these things.
I'll take my second Dedede out.
And yeah, it'd be really cool. If you
well,
can.
Well, I mean, making them more integrated into the games isn't going to keep the people that are buying them without, like, having
it,
Wii U.
It'd be more
from
incentive, yeah.
Them. But it will get the people, because, like, I have a Wii U, and I own three amiibos.
Yeah. I'm just saying that if you create an amiibo that looked like was in a different pose, mm-hmm. people would buy the same amiibo.
They would.
Even though it wouldn't do anything in the game.
My thing is they've got to be careful, because I think one of the best examples of how it's used well is Splatoon, because it unlocks you more stuff to do, but then you got to be careful because you actually have to produce enough, because like people right now are still looking for their stupid little squid that comes in the 3-pack, which is impossible to find, and they can't unlock everything that they want
to
unlock.
Like, and you also got to be careful because people don't want to have to buy an amiibo to unlock things.
So my thing, if you want to do that,
part of it locked away.
I think it'd be a great idea, like have the amiibo, but also have the DLC separate. So, like, you could buy the amiibo and unlock the DLC, or for a reduced price, you could just buy the DLC.
I could dig that.
Yeah, I still don't think it should be... I think it should be strictly extra and not excluding anything.
Like, what they did in Mario Maker. Or have a way to, like, earn it
in the game. Yeah, that too. Like, Mario Maker is just a small little thing, but it was cool.
Well, and that was a great building block. What if one of the NX games... Because at this point, there's no way this doesn't carry over to the NX.
Oh, yeah, no, absolutely.
What if, like, an NX launch game was specifically, just because I know people prefer this more, just anecdotally, Disney Infinity. Like, they just put out their Disney Infinity where you have a sandbox where you can build stuff, add rules to game types, and then you just scan your Luigi and you get to play as Luigi.
Kind of like a Nintendo MMO.
Yeah. Oh, no, that'd be fucking cool. Sell like hotcakes.
Well, I mean, hotcakes... How old am I?
I was looking.
An old man.
Hotcakes!
Basically, on Disney Infinity, like, somebody created Splatoon in that game. They set up all the game rules, and it was awesome. Like,
I forgot about that Nintendo.
People have been asking for a freaking Pokemon MMO for, like, the past, as long as I've been alive.
Jordan means I.
I think it would be cool too.
No, absolutely. But he's
like, people, hey, we like, got that Pokemon.
I've heard of people in far off lands who want this.
Even a 3D Pokemon game we've been waiting for since
Pokemon Go is a step in the right direction. It's not
Stadium,
exactly it, but
Stadium. 3D, everyone loved Stadium.
3D Pokemon game already happened. Jordan
XD was pretty good.
XD and Colosseum were amazing.
3D Pokemon, they exist.
I'm talking about just like the same thing as
X Pokemon. And Y, yeah. Alpha and Omega.
They're on the right
those
track.
Those are 3D. I'm just saying.
They're on the right track.
They're three-dimensional.
All right, but that's not what
they're
we're
not sprite-based.
Yeah, that's pretty.
So earlier today, PlayStation Experience kicked off. That is Sony's little two or three day, I forget exactly. I think it might have started last night, but the keynote was this morning.
Nine days, maybe weeks.
A month. Who knows?
It's fucking PS month.
So it's the PlayStation Expo, and basically they had the keynote this morning. They probably announced some other stuff since I wrote down my notes, but this is what they announced during the keynote. The conference kicked off with Uncharted 4, and the big news here was you will now have dialogue options in the game.
You will now have dialogue options, or you will not have dialogue
you
options?
You will now. Like, okay. They've never done it before.
I haven't played an Uncharted game.
I think it'll be interesting.
Because of the way they did Fallout 4.
I'm annoyed with that, because you don't get a fucking stupid dialogue change. Because they didn't want to have the voice actors go and record stupid dialogue. You don't get low intelligence dialogue.
They were so fun though. There was a character.
You need it in a Fallout game.
There was a character.
Make him record it, goddammit.
In New Vegas.
Put it on his DLC, I'll buy it. I don't give a fuck.
Or who would only join you if you had high enough intelligence, where you could actually like
convince him and engage him.
Or if you had low enough intelligence where he feels sorry for you.
Yeah.
And will join you. That was amazing. New Vegas wasn't even created by Bethesda, and it's still up there. Yeah, Obsidian, who, by the way, I still won't forgive for what they did with KOTOR 2.
I don't believe that was entirely their fault.
They were restricted, yes.
Yeah.
You always feel that in a game where just like, they feel like they had their hands tied behind their hands. And
second actor broken
hands. Hands behind their hands?
Their hands tied behind their backs, and they're typing with their nose.
My hand's like, behind my hand, help!
I gotta finish this in 15 seconds.
So,
time's up.
One thing that actually surprised people, they showed off some of the Final Fantasy VII HD remake, and it looks gorgeous. However, one thing that people are still kind of wary about, the combat system looks like, and I'm told, a lot like Final Fantasy XII's.
I didn't.
It's more. I haven't watched the video yet. I have played a bit of 12 because Mike let me borrow it a while ago, and I'm not sure he knows that I still have it. But Mike let me borrow it a while ago. I've played a bit of 12. It's basically you put in your command, and there's a little timer for until that command is ready to be done, and you're walking around in a 3D space the entire time. So you're dodging shit.
Yeah, and you are doing that for sure.
I was going to say, once your attack is ready, like, let's say you got, like, a fucking, I don't know, I'm gesturing a bomb.
So it's like an actual turn-based round kind
of fuse bomb.
Yeah.
Like, you're just carrying it around, waiting for the fuse to get lit, and then once it's lit, you throw it. Like, you have the command to say, all right, execute the thing that I
sounds like KOTOR.
Kinda, because KOTOR was more of a D&D 3.5.
Yeah, where you click something and they would walk up to them. Yeah,
yeah. It's not this quite one.
You,
that.
You put like a cue in, like if you want to, like,
yeah, and then once attack, that attack,
attack dodge attack.
Once that attack is ready, you actually have to tell it to execute that attack. I think that could work well. I don't see how they could. I was gonna say not ethically. How they could succeed by releasing the same combat system. People wouldn't go to it. It wouldn't work in a modern game.
Yes.
And I hate that, but at the same time, I couldn't get through fucking, what was the 3DS Square game?
Fire Emblem?
No.
Bravely Default.
I couldn't get through Bravely Default. I ended up selling it back. I couldn't get through it because turn-based combat is so boring now.
It's outdated.
Because we have the technology to do dynamic combat and shit, and it works, and now you try and go back. Like, I can play classic Final Fantasy games, and I can play turn-based games that were released then. You can't make a game that is modern and have it work, or at least I haven't seen one that does work.
Yeah, I feel the same way.
Bravely Default exactly sold very well, way. Though.
It did.
Like, Square was all like, oh, people want our old-style games, and, like, everybody who bought it was like, yes.
It did, and for that kind of thing, it was probably good. I just found it, especially with the
Brave... And maybe it's better suited on the handhelds and stuff.
Well, oh, it's...
Yeah, well, and especially with the Brave and Default system, I found myself hitting auto so it would redo my last attacks, just braving all the way and doing my hardest attack... And just going into all fights with auto on. So it would just do that, and I'd clear everything. So it was just walk to the next thing, don't press anything, collect my reward, walk to the next thing, don't press anything, super collect my reward.
Gameplay.
The only thing that mattered was boss fights. Which, like, at the same time, they're trash. Really, you should be able to tear
to everything around them.
Exactly. Exactly. It went from just let the computer auto attack to I have to plan this without a fucking mess up.
Hope you brought 5,000 health potions.
Yeah. I couldn't get through it.
I liked the combat from the Final Fantasy 13 series. I'm like the only person. Yeah. I like
the combat. He's the only system. Person that likes 13.
Did you play all 12 13s?
I played 13. I played a little 13 too. Couldn't get through it.
I can't believe that they made my number the shitty one.
Hey, I like 13.
He's the only person I know
though,
in history
of all 13. Final Fantasies. Oh, no, it is
even 14 is better.
People love 14. I know. Derek loves 14.
14 is the second biggest MMO right now.
Looking at the tapestry that is all of the 14. Final Fantasies, there is one dim spot, and it's 13.
I like
Dirge's. I'm not saying it's terrible because I haven't played it.
I think it's better than 8. I hated 8. I barely.
The story in 8 is weird. My problem with
it. That wasn't my problem with it.
And the junctioning system is broken as shit. The moment you get the death spell, put it on your attack, everything dies. Broken.
That's super fun.
Dirge's Cerberus.
It had a good idea though.
Playing more than 13.
I played all the way through Final Fantasy.
I bought Dirge's Cerberus for like $4 and I still haven't finished it.
I played all the way through Final Fantasy VII without realizing that you could run away from battles, so I fought every single fight I ever got involved in.
Aaron got to the first major
that's
boss
the smart
battle
way to play
in Final
those
Fantasy
games.
IX.
You don't want to run from
without
stuff.
Knowing you could change equipment.
That's XP wasting.
I tried to play three, and I couldn't find out how to run away, so I can't finish it. And then he couldn't beat the boss, so I came over, and I was like, why? Why haven't you changed anything? He's like, oh, well, it wasn't that hard. And I was like, okay. Granted.
So...
I want to state he was like 9,
much younger.
10.
They also the Final Fantasy VII PC port that was moving over to PS4 is out now.
It came out. Okay,
here cool. You go, guys.
Wait, what?
They port the PC port of Final Fantasy VII. They ported to the PS4, and that's out now.
Oh, that's cool.
So if you want to play the
slightly better version, got ported back. to a console from the PC?
Yeah.
Okay.
The port got ported.
The port got ported back.
Well, I mean, it would be easier than porting the PS1 version.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
And I would prefer that they do that so I don't have to fucking sign up for PS Now or whatever it is. I don't fucking want to rent my house and have them for like 12 hours. It's stupid.
Stupid concept. So again, with my favorite announcement, Tim Schafer comes out and announces that Double Fine will be making an HD version of Full Throttle for the PS4 and PS Vita.
I couldn't even tell you what Full Throttle is.
This is one of his more popular adventure games with his time with LucasArts.
Oh, okay. I'll give you that. Okay.
And I'm pumped. Basically, the game is...
I mean, it's not...
You're in a biker game and you're dealing with biker gang politics.
Oh, I play that.
Yeah, that sounds pretty
nice. That sounds pretty different than most things.
The only LucasArts games I know from him are the Monkey Island games.
I don't remember. People love those. I don't remember a ton about it, but like I just remember playing this game all the time with my dad.
It was probably before I was born, or when I was a child.
95.
It would have been
that's
when you were
exactly when I was born.
You're a baby.
Yeah, I'm a baby.
He's only a year younger.
I'm a baby.
I was in school when you were born.
What about 94?
Oh my goodness.
Maybe no. Just starting.
No. I just Pokemon, that's it.
He also said, and I don't know how this fits into if Psychonauts 2 doesn't make it or whatever, they announced Psychonauts VR, a game that will bridge the first and second game. It will be on PlayStation VR, of course, and it will be like a first-person puzzle-based game. Really didn't say a lot, but all I could think is like...
So I have to Metroid, have the VR to play it?
Yeah. That's what it sounds like. So I was thinking like Metroid Prime, VR, Psychonaut.
What is this, Kingdom Hearts? Like, no one played Chain of Memories.
I played Chain of Memories.
I played it, and then I stopped playing because it sucked.
Nobody played Chain of Memories. Three of the four people in this room have played Chain of Memories.
And I've never even gotten halfway through a Kingdom Hearts game.
I full clear Chain of Memories.
I don't know. It's
100% Chain of Memories.
I want to love it. I can't get into it. I own one of them. I've tried.
One of them? Do you have the first one?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that the one you have?
Yeah. Well, I have the
that's what he just said!
I have the HD remake of the first one.
Oh, okay.
And like when we were kids,
so actually he owns the first one. He owns Chain of Memories, and he owns the cutscenes from one of the DS ones.
You can block, by the way. Just to let you know.
Dude, did you know? Did you know
blocks.
That? And I learned this from Did You Know Gaming. That the cutscene, the hidden cutscene at the end of one, was not meant to be part of two. It was supposed to be like just kind of a general concept of what a sequel might be kind of like.
Then it didn't happen in two.
I thought part of the cutscene did.
Nope.
Of what cutscene?
The area that they use, what the area in the cutscene is in two.
Uh-huh.
But the cutscene itself happens at the end of 358.
Oh, well, it wasn't meant to be part of the story in general.
Right.
I don't even know what you guys are talking about, the cutscene.
It's the cutscene where Roxas goes to fight Riku.
Oh, yeah.
My dog's a fucking beast.
Yeah, Roxas goes to fight Riku because Sora's memories are going back into Sora, which is throwing up off the Roxas balance, and he's all like, I don't get it. And Riku's all like, you're the last thing I need to defeat so my friend can wake up.
Yeah, I never I have never 100%
nobody's.
I can't even get an Ultima weapon. It's just too much farming.
Shit, I have 100% too and fucking grinded the shit out of it to get everything maxed out.
I hate farming so much.
Ratchet & Clank HD Remake, the game based off the movie based off the game, has a release date of April 4th, 2016.
Yeah. Dude, Street Fighter the movie, the game, was the original. That's all I'm saying. It's the
best. It looks really good. Like, I've seen, like, they did everything from scratch.
Good.
I like that series.
And what did Matt tell me that they were making from the ground up? I don't know.
Ratchet Deadlock was my favorite.
Remember later.
Sparrow Racing is coming to Destiny probably by the time you're listening to this podcast on Tuesday, December 8th. Something people have been asking for a while. And that was the last bit that I was really interested in. They announced like Ni No Kuni 2 if you're into JRPGs and stuff like that.
I tried to play that.
While they're, as I put here, while they...
Was that the one that was kind of like Pokemon-ish?
It's really weird.
There were a bunch of other announcements, but compared to... Sony's had great conferences all year. This kind of felt weak in comparison, especially considering this is supposed to be your your hardcore fans are here. Like, these are the people who buy the Vita and stuff that are sitting in front of you. Like, talk to them more about that kind of
stuff. Show them something about the Vita.
And they did.
Something.
Like, they've abandoned ship on the Vita.
Oh, the first party has.
Yeah.
A lot of the third parties, like the people who made Guacamelee, they're all like, we actually, because we set our expectations, got a pretty decent profit off the Vita version.
I wonder if they have Abyss Odyssey in the Vita.
Because they're not Double Fine and they know how to work within their limitations and set goals.
And like the Danganronpa people, speaking of your books... Like, they make money on it.
Picture books, man.
And Japanese animes.
Japanese anime.
Do you have to swipe left? Like, you're...
No. Dude, a fucking... What are they called?
The game.
What are they called? Those type of games?
Visual novels?
Visual novels. Fucking visual novel that's just, like, an anime Tumblr. You just get to swipe left and swipe right. It's just a dating sim.
Well, most of them are dating sims. I mean, about 90% of them are dating sims.
Although one of the ones he's played, there was an anime adaptation. It was pretty good.
Oh, yeah. Vertigrisaya. It's good.
What are you shushing him about?
I don't know.
I thought he was going to mention that it's a porn game.
Oh.
Yes.
Jordan watches porn.
Oh, man. What?
I can't believe you watch porn. Like, nobody watches porn. That's so
gross. I read porn.
That's degrading.
Okay. Dude, that's degrading. I made a comment. Oh, because somebody uses the code name Deep Throat at some point in Metal Gear Solid. I made the comment that is the grossest sound in porn to me. Just that.
No, oh, I hate it.
That right there. Like,
nope.
Off. Done. Yeah. Gone. Bye.
Yep. And
fast forward blowjobs.com.
And
I don't know if it's a website. Just Google it.
It probably is.
You get some funny noises. If you're under 18, don't Google that. I don't want to get sued.
And depending on where you live, if you're under 21, don't Google that.
That, yeah. If you're Mormon, don't Google that.
Jesus will not like that.
Oh my God. But, oh God. Soaking is fine.
Anyway.
Let's move on from that.
We have
Mormons know what I'm talking about.
If you wanted to send us mail, Seth. Where could you email us?
All right, I know this. NIBScast@gmail.com?
Oh, man, we're getting there, guys.
I would not have been able
to. Dude, they all got it right last week.
I'm proud of it. Yeah. I'm proud of the group.
I got it. I did it.
You did it.
You did it.
Next time, I got to know to ask Jordan that question, clearly.
I think last time me and him were on, you asked him. He did not know.
No, I did not.
Hey, learn the email address.
I mean, it's
disrespectful. That's what it is.
So, unless anybody has anything major to talk about, we can go around the room. What are you guys playing?
League of Legends still sucks.
Yeah.
I was just forced to watch a commercial on YouTube about how League of Legends brings people together from, like, Israel and Norway.
Mm-hmm. Tears friendships apart.
Okay, not if you're playing Cody Slinker, I'm telling you that right now. You hearing that, Cody?
I've met so many friends. Yeah, and you've probably met, like, infinitely times more enemies.
I've never made a... Well, actually, that's not true. I hated them anyway.
I played one round of LoL.
You remember Ahmad? Well, I hated playing with that kid.
That AD Elise.
I really liked the game until I played with some kid Mike met at Crazy Penguins or whatever that place was.
Oh, Club Penguin? Oh, Crazy Penguin. Yeah, I know that.
Not Club Penguin.
Club Penguin's the Disney-owned social site.
Make swastikas out of characters.
No, he met this kid, and he was so bad at the game. But like, he just talked all the shit in the world, even to his team. So, like, he's sitting there like, God, you suck. I'm like, I've got more kills than you, asshole.
The worst part about...
So, it's like playing with Mike?
I mean, if Mike's not that bad for me, so maybe for you, yeah.
I'm just... I'm talking about Smite specifically.
I never
But, like, Smite, so every time I'd play Smite with Derek and... Who did I play? Derek, Mike, Phil? And Phil.
Fucking Phil.
Derek would sit there and just whisper me, don't listen to them. What do you want me to do, Derek? Whatever they are telling you, do the opposite. They don't know what they're talking about. And like, Mike would be like, why the fuck did you do that? You're doing it wrong. And Derek's just like, dude, no, you're doing fine. It's okay.
The painters have a problem.
No, but okay. Anyway, Mike didn't like this kid either. The only reason we played with him is he thought his sister was hot.
I mean, worth, right?
He thought his own sister was hot?
No, this kid that we were playing with, sister. Like, he only let him play...
So oh, because Mike thought his sister was hot.
Sounds like a Mike thing.
I thought you were saying that kid thought his own sister was hot.
Morale of the story.
League sucks. I hate that game.
Bubbles are kind of a problem right now.
They're breeding grounds for toxicity.
And dude.
I want to get a... Can I say something about Heroes?
Oh, how they added...
How they changed it so you actually see your kills and assists now. They took... You know how it just said takedowns? Like, takedowns and deaths. That's all they had. Now they have kills, deaths, and assists, like League of Legends. And that pisses me off. Because now people are going to be like, oh, look at you, you only had 3 kills and 6 deaths. It's like, yeah, but I got 22 assists over here.
Well, and... I fucking did objectives, so suck it, Scrub.
Yeah, so you can be, you can be.
I hate those systems of.
So are you up to Hero League yet?
I don't play ranked.
Dude, play ranked. It is so much better.
Well, I've played it, but because every single time
so
I
many
game,
of those people,
I play with him and like Kyle.
Well, so many of those people aren't in ranked.
And even if it's those people, they don't act like that in ranked.
Exactly.
I don't know why quick match people are trying.
Exactly.
I don't know why you pick Murky in quick match. Stop
God,
it.
Fucking Murky, dude.
Stop it.
Murky's a badass.
Not in quick match when you're playing on a map he sucks at.
I'm sick of that hero.
Have you played the Immortals map with a Murky on your team? It's the most cancerous.
I've played against the Murkys that kicked my ass on that map.
How are my Cho'Gall herpes going, by the way?
I still don't have it. I haven't played Heroes.
I infected
him. Or Jordan.
Julio keeps wanting me to play. Like, I get messages on Facebook, like, every
I saw
other
that.
Day. Like,
yeah.
Hey, how about we play some fucking Hero League? Hey, I'm rank one. I'm like, yeah. Yeah, Julio's a beast. I fucking got him to try the game. Within a week, he was in Hero League. Oh, the guy does not fuck around.
Them boosts, though. The XP boosts.
No.
No?
No?
None of those?
Nope.
He needed to play like the entire week then.
Yeah, no. Yeah. Julio doesn't fuck around.
Julio.
He is amazing with Tyrael.
You think he mid-maxes?
He plays fucking the Protoss that gets the wall.
Tassadar?
Yeah. He fucking plays Tassadar. He's a beast with that wall. It's amazing.
Oh, going against a good Tassadar is really, really annoying.
But he does the same thing with fucking Tyrael's sword. Like, he will kite people and then just hop back to the other side of him and go a different way.
Yeah.
And just
bait and switch.
Every fucking time.
The bait and switch, yeah.
It's amazing because I'm usually with him and then I end up dying because they go after me then.
That's part of his plan.
Oh, yeah. No, absolutely. I'm just going to follow Hammer. I'll be right back.
So, have you played a real game at all this week?
Me?
A real game? I'm sure you've played, like, Fallout 4.
Yeah, Jordan Kuhn.
I've been playing a bit of Fallout 4.
I know you've been leveling on WoW.
Dude, I saw your fucking rolling pin.
What?
Your fucking rolling pin.
Yeah. I found this legendary rolling pin, and I was just like, "Are you?" I thought this was trash, and I never picked it up. I thought it was like wood. Nope. It, like, it was worth 1 wood. It's a weapon. And then I souped it up to be made of aluminum, and it's like duct
tape. It's got like razor.
Yeah, it has razor. I'm like, okay, yep, like
bake the cookies.
Oh my god,
dude! I found a legendary machete. It's in area, like it's a constant spawn. It's not a random drop. This legendary machete that's a sacrificial
dagger.
Yeah,
I just found that.
Yeah, and it causes bleed and poison.
That
Ooh. It's pretty fucking sweet.
That instance,
Dunwich Borers.
It was really that was a really cool area.
Well, you remember, I don't remember if it was 3 or New Vegas, but they had the Dunwich building where you go downstairs and it's Cthulhu.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is. Dunwich Horror was the first H.P. Lovecraft story to include Cthulhu or any of it. So that's why the place is called Dunwich Borers. Because they bore into the ground because they're a quarry.
That's pretty cool. Because I just found that place. I'm at the point now
I saw
where
the thing pop up on my map with the name, and I was like, I have to go visit there now. I have to just go see what that is.
You were getting like flashbacks of what it was.
It was cool.
In life. Yeah, it was really nice.
And then you walk around that corner, and there's just dudes praying to something, and then you get attacked by all of those dudes as ghouls.
Yeah, because it flashbacks, and they're already back up, and they're chasing you. Like, if I didn't have the most powerful weapon in the game right now, I would be scared.
I don't have the most powerful weapon.
I found a combat rifle that shoots additional projectile each shot.
I just got a pistol that does that. I didn't know that it didn't take 2 ammo to do it.
Those are very strong weapons. It doubles the DPS of a weapon.
It does.
You can get a fat man called Big Boy from Arturo in Diamond City. Uh-huh. The weapons vendor. It shoots 2 projectiles.
It shoots 2
I saw somebody. I saw a GIF of somebody doing that because they had bats up. And it just missed with both of them.
Field goal.
You just see him pause. Load.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, it's the game. I think the legendary portion of that game is a really good concept. And
yes, I think they did it well too.
And extends the game a bit for those people that like to mid max.
Yeah.
So
now, if there was a way that like we could come visit each other's settlements, so we could show off our weapons, I think that'd be cool. Don't get me wrong.
I do not want fucking
Fallout Online
coming next year.
Actually, that contradicts the statement I made a couple weeks ago. I think Fallout Online would be much better than Elder Scrolls Online.
Oh, at the Game Awards, they announced a expansion.
Rust for
Elder Scrolls Online?
Oh, yeah. Oh, for Elder Scrolls?
Does anyone care
about that game?
So, Elder Scrolls Online was your Elder Scrolls 6. Now your Elder Scrolls 7's down the drain. Sorry, guys.
Damn it. Come on, man. Get your heads together.
They just come back up
Skyrim
with Elder Scrolls
2, please. 8. I wouldn't mind going to elsewhere.
That
come
would
on.
Be really funny. They're just like, dude, Elder Black Scrolls Marsh. 8 coming out. What?
Black Marsh. Oh, my God. Dang. The Argonians.
2020 please. Sounds about right for the next Bethesda Studios game.
I mean, if you're going to release your Skyrim
2011, that's 6 years. Four. So 9 wouldn't be too much of a leap.
It's kind of like what Windows did, just like Windows 8 and then Windows 10. Yeah. Like, well, what happened to Windows 9? We don't talk about Windows 9.
Yeah. Elder Scrolls 7, let's do it.
Please. Like, I just want to forget about that.
No, that's the expansion pack. 7's gone.
Yeah, I would
they're
like
starting back up with 8.
I would like Fallout Online, but it's been done by so many indie corporations, just the concept of it.
Yeah.
The survival. Mm-hmm.
But it's not been done in Fallout, so it's could
Fallout
still
universe,
work.
Like the story of Fallout's
yeah.
pretty awesome.
Yeah. And that's what would set it apart.
Yeah, it would be the story.
They would take out the settlements because that would be awkward to do in an MMO. Unless garrisons. They made it like garrisons and you only had one settlement.
Garrisons, guys.
I can't wait to build a castle in Elder Scrolls 6.
Their cool. version of garrisons.
No, not actually that. Like, I'm just saying, like, with the build system they put in and, with Fallout 4, like, yeah, and well, the proper
the
Elder Scrolls 6,
oh,
like,
gotcha.
I want to build
I
a castle.
You see,
oh, in 6. See, for some reason, that's what you meant online.
For Skyrim was alpha for the house building.
Oh, yeah.
Then the
dude, I figured out how to build houses without them being shit.
I want to build a castle in Elder Scrolls 8.
No, I figured out how to build houses without them looking like shit.
Yeah.
I was so happy. My buildings don't look like shit now.
On what?
In Fallout.
Yeah, me too.
There's that moment where you're like, oh, I get this now. I can make things that don't look like ass.
Yeah. The tutorial for the building in
except
that game.
I wish you could
there
lock,
is no tutorial.
Yeah. I wish you could lock the angle with the foundation that's
yes.
down.
Yes.
So,
yes.
like, it's not coming off the back corner.
I know how to make foundations now.
I was in the
thanks, game, for telling me
I
that.
I was in the Fallout subreddit early on, and, like, they were discussing, they're like, I want to figure this game out by myself, but, like, are we concerned that, like, cheating if we look up how to, and everybody's like, no. This is so poorly explained, you can, with a good conscience, look everything about this up and not be like you cheated.
Well, and it has that bit for workshops in yeah. your Pip-Boy, and it just has, like a fucking caution
yeah.
flag next to
it. Doesn't tell you what it's about.
Doesn't tell you why. I keep going back to Sanctuary because it has a fucking caution flag next to it. Not getting attacked. They have all their needs met. I don't know what the fuck
you?
They need. What?
Does one of them have a quest for you to go take care of some ghouls or something?
That's on the other
sure
side of
Preston
the entire
does,
city.
Because he always does.
Yeah, I was talking to Seth earlier, and he was like,
oh, that's why I ended up going to
more work for you.
Because Preston sent me there on a thing.
It's like, oh man, we have some ghouls that are causing us trouble. Oh yeah, where are they at? Freaking southeast side of the map. It's like, how are they bothering
you?
You
guys
got
to the glowing
city. How?
Yeah.
I just did that. Because I've been avoiding doing the actual story.
Yeah.
But I was like, I'm going to do another part of the story and then stop there and do some more shit.
There's nothing in there, but it's a cool zone.
Yeah, there's nothing there. That kind of bummed me out. Except for the crater.
Yeah. And I was talking to Seth
earlier. I feel like you can eventually make that a settlement. I feel like you might be able to.
Maybe, but there would be no reason to. By the way, screw the children of Adam. They're the worst enemies to go against in that game, in my opinion.
Yep.
They're awful.
Plasma guns.
Plasma guns? You're using plasma guns against
you? The first ones that I ran into, they were fighting some gunners. They had fucking plasma guns.
Just wait until you find them and they have gamma guns. Those are the worst thing.
Gamma
yeah.
guns is what
gamma
I mean.
Guns are awful.
Yeah, no, they're awful.
You just
fucking
see
the worst.
Like your permanent HP going down. I'm like,
yep.
Jeez. I had swallowed Radex just before then.
Mm-hmm.
And it was still doing like a shit ton. I was like, what is
quit.
This?
You know, it's
and
awful.
And drink some Radaway. Sorry.
You know, it's awful. It's the worst.
So what have you been playing this week, Seth?
I've been jumping around between a lot of stuff. Bit of Diablo 3 PTR. Little bit of Fallout 4 still. Bit of Rogue Legacy. I've been playing that again. I'm not sure if you guys know what that is.
Have you
is.
Gotten the hidden class yet? Oh, we know what it is.
The hidden class?
Yeah, there's a hidden class.
Oh.
The dragon.
Those, the dragon?
The dragon.
No, that's not the hidden class.
Yeah, it is.
There's a hidden class where you can get the final boss as a class.
Now they updated.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to beat four bosses that are hard as hell, though.
Oh yeah, no, I know.
I can't do it.
After trying about the upgrade versions of
those? Yeah, they're freaking hard as hell,
dude. The ones where you have to pay the coin for them.
Yeah, you have to beat the actual boss, then find a coin from one of the statues, and then die and give it to the guy up front, and then you're like, oh, I can fight these bosses.
That and you go in as a preset class with
preset stats. Oh, they are.
I got really close to I don't remember which one it is, but the eyeball. I got really close to killing him once.
Yeah, I got close to killing him. I didn't try him too much. I tried the second boss a whole bunch of times, but that was the first one I found.
Is that the skull?
Yeah, the skull that shoots.
That was the first one I found too.
Fuck that.
I didn't
boss,
beat that
man.
Game, by the way.
Fuck that.
I just stopped playing it. It was a good game.
I never tried any like super difficult bosses more than once or twice, but
I really like roguelikes. The type roguelike.
I had a lot of fun playing that game. What else have I played?
What was the game Justin and I played the other day? Basically, you had a sack of coins, and those were your attacks and healing and whatnot. And every time you got into a fight, you would just grab some coins out of your pouch, and you could choose like one of the ones to send out. And then it was cool. I'll figure out what the name was. I'm sure you guys.
I played a little StarCraft too.
Yeah, I finished the StarCraft 2 campaign. It's really good.
I have yet to play it.
It's really good.
I heard the end is, like, really hard.
The end?
The outro.
Just because they make you play Terran, and like, if you haven't played Terran for, like, two expansions, so they just thrust it upon you. It's a really tough mission, too, and you're just like, how do you play this? I'm just going to make 10 barracks.
I don't remember how to play this.
I'm just going to make 10 barracks and 20 marines each spawn and just send them to... Because it's the entire mission itself isn't hard. It's just like you have to defend 3 points, but there's an achievement where you have to make sure your partner's nexuses don't fall, and they're dumb. They were really dumb. You have Artanis as a hero class, like a hero unit. The first wave that comes in, he'll jump in and he'll die instantly. He'll just... And then, like, they have, like, 10 mutilists just raining on the guy, and he can't hit them. He's just, like, looking at them like, you're hurting me. And he dies. He doesn't come back. Zagara comes back. And you have to... There's just, like, endless hordes coming in. And there's a few of those kind of missions, you know. You're going against, you know, Amon or whatever like that. And it was satisfying, though, because once you got past that mission, you never had to play Terran ever again. I think Terran's awful. So
I showed Julio the other day, because he fucking loves StarCraft. Mm-hmm. I showed him the realistic cinematic for Void.
Because this is an audio podcast, what we just tried to describe with our... Basically, it has like the beautiful rendered Blizzard cutscene, and then it'll cut to like the units actually fighting in the game,
which is just them slapping each other.
Yeah, it's like watching a RuneScape fight or something.
Fucking RuneScape. What have you been playing, Nick?
He's been playing yawning.
The yawning.
Fallout 4. A little bit of Metal Gear Solid, the first one. Mostly, and you'll see this when we get to it, mostly Matt would get stuck on fights because, like, I forgot how shitty the controls are for the first one. With the aiming specifically. Because shooting is square. If you hold square and you're vaguely facing somebody, you will gravitate towards them. But they don't explain that.
It's true. They don't.
So I had forgotten to tell him about that. I had actually forgotten that was a thing until he got to the Ocelot fight. And he just couldn't do it, and I was like, I don't remember being this hard. So I grabbed the controller and I died a couple of times, and I was like, oh shit, that's right, aiming is a thing, hold on. And I beat it, and I was like, okay, so next time. And I explained it to him, but mostly beating bosses that Matt couldn't quite get, which didn't happen too often. He's doing pretty good.
I hate dual use controls for those kind of games. Like, a big problem I have with Fallout is the bash button is the same as, if you hold it down, as the grenade button.
Yeah.
But once you have that grenade, like, primed...
There's no way to not.
Yeah, so I'm just like, fuck.
I gotta hold this forever. I might have said it last week on the podcast. I was ducked behind a barricade, like one of those cement street barricades.
Yeah.
And there was a turret on the other side, and I was gonna throw a grenade at it. So I arm it,
and I think I'm looking over the thing, and I'm not, and I throw it, it hits it, shoots up in the air, and I thought, okay, I'm fine, it'll blow up. Lands with enough time for me to turn the fuck around, and then all of a sudden it just, third person, I have no arms.
Yeah. Explosions in that game are really bad, because some enemies will have Fat Mans.
Oh, yeah.
And there's no counterplay to that.
I came up on a raider that was in power armor and had a Fat Man. Like, the moment it turned to caution, he just automatically fired.
Yeah, it doesn't matter, because even if he dies, you die, so you have to start it over again.
Yep.
That's a stupid concept. You shouldn't have that in a game.
Fucking,
some insta-death with those missile launchers. Fat.
On the PC version, I want to ask you guys, because my PC is not good enough to run it. I've been playing on PS4. On the PC version, do your pulse grenades look good?
I don't really use grenades.
The pulse grenades. Never mind. I don't use pulse grenades. No.
Have you used them at any point?
Mm-mm.
Okay. There is an issue with the PS4 version for some reason, and I actually took the initiative to go to Bethesda's website and tell them about it, which apparently a bunch of people were having. The PS4 version, there is a corrupted texture file for the actual electricity shooting out of the pulse grenades.
Yeah.
So it just turns to this giant black fucking opaque mesh.
Really?
And then it just disappears.
That looks funny.
it's fucking awful. It looks terrible. That's
pretty bad.
And it's incredibly distracting because you can't see through it.
Right.
So, yeah. Like, you can't hit anything on the other side of the explosion. It's ridiculous. So hopefully they fix that soon.
Hopefully.
That's the first bug that I'm like, okay, this isn't okay. Last week we were talking about how, like, Bethesda can totally release games that are full of bugs and just bugs out the ass. And we don't care.
They get a free pass.
We don't fucking care. Because it's we really want to play the game.
They get a free pass on all releases.
Absolutely.
Oh, it's such a big and expansive game. So there's bound to be bugs everywhere.
Exactly.
Right?
And, like, you don't care. Because, like, okay.
You can't get away with that.
I listened to an interesting interview with an Obsidian guy. And he was saying when they were working on New Vegas, because they just used the Fallout 3 engine for it, they were all like... People, for some odd reason, this time around, people are complaining about this all of a sudden. They're like, for everybody who likes those mods, the only reason these mods are this easy to implement into the game is the engine.
Right.
And the bugs are just something that comes along with this engine. Like,
yeah.
Sorry, if you want mods, you gotta deal
modding
with
modding on Bethesda games is some of the easiest modding ever.
Yeah.
Like, you go and try and mod other games, it's just, like, such a pain.
And well, like they were saying, like, Witcher 3 is the big thing. Like, everybody's like, well, Witcher 3 runs so well. It's like, you can't pick up, like, everything in Witcher 3.
Yeah.
Like, you can basically pick everything up in Fallout 4.
Yeah, there's so much clutter, and you need the clutter. And just the engines in general for Bethesda games are...
There's a legendary Fat Man. But there's 3 desk fans, and I can only carry 2 of those.
Oh, you pick desk fans every time.
Desk fans. I need screws.
Desk fans.
Yeah.
Screws, desk gears. Fans, man.
Desk fans are the
light
best.
Bulbs, you take every light bulb you see.
Oh,
you
just that like, copper, dude. You gotta get that copper.
So because you have enough copper in a light bulb to fucking stretch from power pole to power pole.
Obviously. You, from an entire ruined house, you get 10 steel.
Yep.
And that's 5 cans.
Yep.
I'm like, man.
To round this out, I've put...
I'm going to just take that audio of math, and that's going to be the new ding on the thing.
Math! Math!
I have played absolutely no Fallout this week. I have played nothing but Battlefront. I got that game, and it is so good.
One. Are you literally serious?
It is so good.
I've heard... Oh, my God. Like,
I've heard...
Here's people don't... People... Basically, it's funny now. Everybody... Anecdotally, of course, everybody was complaining... That, oh, this game isn't Battlefront. This isn't Battlefront. The game came out, was Battlefront, and now they're like, oh, it needs to be more like Battlefield.
Really?
Really?
Yeah.
That's
anecdotally, of course, from what I see online, but still, like...
Those people didn't play Battlefront 2. They did not. That game was perfect, and it was 2005.
I don't know if it was perfect, but it was a hell of a lot
of fun.
But
no, there's tons of game modes. Derek got me into the, like... Squadron fighter, where you're actually flying around shooting people. That's tons of fun.
Well, the thing is, I only heard that there's only a few game modes that are actually worth it.
I've enjoyed all the ones I've played so far.
I've
so
heard like, the
Walker Salt's the biggest
one. I've played
one.
Like 7 out of, I don't know how many they have. I think they have like 10, and
but
I've enjoyed them
so
all.
But there's so few maps.
Yeah, I've also heard there's a lot of low map. It, like, most game modes only have like 4 or 5 maps in rotation.
A couple of them do, yeah.
Which
I but
think
I mean,
is kind of...
But it's one of the, it's one of those things that like, I always look at like
player only.
A game like Counter-Strike that people love and adore and have played for how many years now? Most people only play on D, Dust 2.
Yeah, there's only one map.
They either play on D Dust 2 or D Dust, or they play custom maps.
True.
And
I don't know. It doesn't. It doesn't
TFC
bother me
custom maps. Let's play turkey burgers tonight. Because
like some of my favorite game types have more than one, and typically, like you said, there's 4 planets right now, and each one has a map on those planets. But like the game modes I enjoy, like the team deathmatch and all that, they have like 2 for each planet.
Okay.
So
well, that's not too bad.
I want to do a NIBS tournament.
Turkey burgers?
No. Well, maybe turkey burgers. No NIBS tournament. Ooh, we could do a conk. I don't know that there'd be a tournament, but we'll figure that out. No, NIBS tournament, where we draft 2 teams. Like, it's me and you, and we draft our teams out of everybody else, then just play TFC.
Oh, God. You're going down.
Why is he on my team?
Oh, no, I was just looking at him.
Okay.
Thank you.
I mean, you can be on my team.
You're going down.
Why does he get to decide who's on my team?
What is this game?
It's not you, it's him.
Well, because Jordan's going to get picked last. And even if I have to pick him, I'm just going to be like, and we're good.
What are you guys even talking about?
I don't even know what game you're talking
about.
Team Fortress Classic.
Oh, Team Fortress Classic?
Well, guess what? I've played Overwatch. That means I have practice now with those kind of games.
Not Team Fortress Classic.
Good luck, kid.
No.
Whatever.
Team Fortress Classic is not TF2.
But yeah, about
Battlefront. Not even a little.
There's gonna be
sensor grenades.
There's gonna be
what? And they matter.
There's gonna be sentry guns in places you had no ideas, and pirates.
They're gonna be floating in the middle of the air with their base weighed out on the ground that doesn't take damage.
Sounds like a perfect game.
God, I wish that was still a fucking played game. Oh my god.
I know, it's just like stupid easy bots anymore.
It was so good.
Anyway.
And that was like 1999.
Jeez. I
was 4 years old.
Perfect game. 1999.
We'll start rounding out the show and get out of here for the week. Plug some things. I'm working on my South Park The Stick of Truth NIBS play. I didn't post it the last 2 days because I didn't have a lot of free time, and I played Battlefront during my free time. Sorry about that. But I posted one today, and we should be good for the next week or so.
There we go.
You guys are working on?
Yeah, me and Matt are recording the Metal Gear Solid playthrough. I have not been consistent in my episode lengths because I just kind of kept remembering, oh shit, I should probably make a new episode now. So they're like 20 to like 40 minutes per episode.
What I'm doing with South Park is I'm setting a 30-minute timer, and then what,
like the good,
whatever
the first
good,
good place
spot,
after that, yeah.
Or like if I'm at like 28.
I just kept forgetting. Like every time I'd look at my clock and end an episode, I just then wouldn't set a timer because I'm an idiot. So there's also 3 phone calls that you guys get to listen to because we kept playing the game while we were on the phone.
It always happens.
Yeah.
All right, so this was another episode of NIBScast. NIBScast is a production of NIBSmedia. If you've liked what you've just heard, go ahead and subscribe to us on that YouTube channel. I swear to God, our iTunes thing is coming. My dad told me to look at the prices for that again.
Look, my blister's almost healed.
Oh, very nice.
Anyway.
My dad told me to take a look at the prices for the RSS feed again. He's going to support us to get on iTunes.
Swag!
It's coming at some point. Yeah, go follow that link down at the bottom. Go to our Facebook page. Give us a like there. We'd appreciate your support. Until next week, I am Aaron.
I'm Nike13.
I'm Seth.
And I'm Jordan.
We'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Spacebar. 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 Just hit.
Fucking horrible.
And every time you made like a step on like, on wood, it would just go.
Just, that's fucking hilarious.
I wonder if you can find that on Nexus Mods.
It probably
sure
is.
You can. Jeez, I might have to play me some Morrowind.
Please, every sound of our.
I found it fucking instantly, too.
That's somebody walking towards you.
Yeah, right? You see him coming towards you in the background.
Tucker, it's okay. Jordan, would you mind just opening the cage?
Opening it?
Yeah, just letting him out. And then just close the door. Man. Because he's not going to follow you in. He's afraid of you. Tucker, leave it.
What the fuck?
It's like randomly, it's just louder. Because it's closer to the cage.
He's bound.
It just walks away.
Oh my god.
Every time I've ever started a character on Morrowind, I've always ransacked the shit out of this room.
Oh yeah. You take everything you can.
The old guy.
All the sound files.
You don't even know what's actually happening because it's just all the same sound.
I told you, even like confirmation text. He just looks at you with his freaking dead eyes.
So yeah, that's what that is.
That's fucking hilarious.
But then it spawned into us just using that in random words, like Aaron mentioning that he really wanted to go to be
Faru. And Kyle. Because Kyle wasn't there, so we're like, where's Kyle?
Oh, you're saying Kyle?
Yeah.
Oh. I just heard
Cree. Cree. Chris Daughtry.
Tucker, leave it.